Hello everyone, today we are going to learn the Kirchhoff's laws. In case of simple circuits, we can use the Ohm's law to find the current and voltage. Whereas in case of complex circuits, we cannot use the Ohm's law. Therefore, we are going to learn the Kirchhoff's law. There are two laws in Kirchhoff's laws. They are junction or current law, and the second law is loop or voltage law. The first law states that the algebraic sum of current meeting at a junction will be equal to zero. That is, summation I in a junction will be equal to zero. For example, if we consider a junction A and currents I1, I2 and I3 in this junction, then the total sum will be equal to zero. Let us solve this. I1 plus I2 minus I3 will be equal to zero. Here the current is positive or negative based on the direction of the current. As you see, the current I1 and I2 are positive because they are moving towards the junction, whereas the current I3 is negative because it is moving away from the junction. This law is also called as the conservation of electric charge, because in this junction, the electric charge can either be built up or disappear from this junction. So this is the current law. Moving on to the voltage law. The voltage law states that the algebraic sum of potential difference in a closed circuit will be equal to zero. Or in other words, the algebraic sum of product of current and resistance will be equal to zero. This can be proved using the Ohm's law. In this law, the direction of the potential difference is depending on the direction of the current. For example, if a current flows from the loop A to B through a resistance R, if you consider the loop A to B, then the potential difference will be plus IR. If you consider the loop B to A, then the potential difference will be considered to be minus IR. Positiveness or the negativeness of the potential difference is determined by the direction of the current and the direction of the loop in which we consider it. So these are the Kirchhoff's laws. The main important applications of Kirchhoff's laws are the Wheatstone bridge, the meter bridge and the potentiometer. To understand this in a better way, now we are going to apply this in the Wheatstone bridge. A Wheatstone bridge is mainly used to compare the resistance or to find an unknown resistance. It consists of four different resistors connected in a series to form a loop. Let us consider the resistors to be P, Q, R and S. And the junctions be considered as A, B, C and D. A galvanometer is connected between the junction B and D. A power supply is connected between the junction A and C. Now, when the external supply produces the current, a current of I flows to the junction A. At the junction A, it is split into I1 and I2, and at the junction B it is again split into I3 and IG, and in junction D it is split into I4, and at junction C it is again combined to form I, because as per the law of conservation of electric charge, the charge produced should be leaving the loop. Now we are going to apply the current law at the junction B and D. By applying the current law at junction B, we can see current I1 moving towards the junction and current IG moving away from the junction. So we can write minus IG and current I3 moving away from the junction. So minus I3 is equal to 0 at B. Now considering at D, a current I2 flows towards the junction, a current IG flows towards the junction, and a current I4 flows away from the junction. Now we are going to consider the loop A, B, D, A, and we are going to apply the voltage law A, B, D, A. By applying the voltage law, IP, I1P plus IGG minus I2R is equal to 0. And again, considering the loop ABCDA and applying the voltage law, we can find I1P plus I3Q minus I4S minus I2R is equal to 0. So let us name these equations as 1, 2, 3 and 4 respectively. Now let us consider a condition that the junction B and D are in same potential. That is, this is called as the balancing condition, and when the potential difference is same, there will be no current flow between this junction. That is, IG will become 0. Applying this condition in the first three equations, we can find I1 minus I3 is equal to 0, or I1 is equal to I3. And similarly, I2 minus I4 is equal to 0, or I2 is equal to I4. And applying it in the third equation, I1P is equal to I2R. Let this equation be 5. Applying the equation number 5 in equation number 4, we can solve the equation as, we can replace I1P with I2R. I2R plus I3Q minus I4S minus I2R. As you can see, there is a positive I2R and a negative I2R. So these can be cancelled, and moving the negative potential to the other side, I3Q is equal to I4S. This can be the equation 6. On dividing equation 5 and 6, we can find that P by Q is equal to R by S. This is called as the balancing condition. Only in this condition, the galvanometer will show null deflection. At this state, we can find the unknown resistance if we know the value of other three resistance, or we can compare the resistance of two resistors with the other two. So far we have learned the Kirchhoff's laws and the application of Kirchhoff's law in the Wheatstone bridge. Thank you.